Back at it again. The fun never slows down on HPI Guys Workshop, which stands for Happy Guys Workshop. I know some of you ask, so every once in a while I toss it into the video. We've got MPC via Round 2 Models bringing back the Barris T Buggy. Yes, this is an awesome customizing kit. I love customizing kits because you can either build it as the box art or you can build your own and no one can say, well, actually, that's not how that kit should be built. You can do it however you want, and that's what makes these so fun and stress-free, more so than even regular models are stress-free. They've got three ways you can build this kit up. You can build it as the buggy version with open top, the Landau version with the fabric top, or the truck buggy version. And now we all know by the title card how I decided to build mine up, but we will start showing you the parts as you can get yours on pre-order right now. So I will get some stuff out on the table. We've got a nice clear tree. This cool looking half moon is when you do the Landau top. We've got our glass. Front and rear, we've got our big bug headlights, like the T's should have. We've got a set of big and littles, one set of tires, nice Goodyears, name brand on both sides, tire size and everything listed on there. Excellent tread. These should look pretty cool when sanded down. The fronts as well are Goodyears, branded all the way around, so you can really bring that out. We've got a beautiful set of decals here. All the pinstripes needed to reproduce what you see on the box art are included on the decal sheet with some bonus stuff in there so people know what it is. We got the Barris T Buggy. We got, is this possibly for the hood? I can't see it in the box image. We've got for around the truck body. We've got interior decals for that truck body if you wanted to make it a delivery for Luigi's Pizza. And then we've got numerous other scallops, crosses, little Barris T Buggy, MPC logos. We'll stop right there so you can pause it and see that lovely decal sheet. We've got a good sized chrome tree. You don't have to use everything on here, but I think you'll end up using a lot of it. In fact, you might end up using a lot of it since it's not really a 3-in-1 kit except for the top. It's even got windshield wipers in there. Lots of suspension components, some roll cage pieces, windshield, nice looking grill there. Black wash inside, one set of wheels with a spare, got a moon tank halves there. We've got parts, quite a bit of our engine is done up in chrome. We know how I always feel about that. Then we got the front suspension and everything. That's that right there. Let's take a look at what else we got going on. The rest of the model is molded in plain styrene, which is yellow, so that you can build the box top version and not have to do a lot of painting if you so desire. We've got our frame here. We've got suspension, looks like. We've got halves of it. It's got a Corvair engine in it, is what it runs on, an opposed six-cylinder. Got a belt and pulley system, springs. Got one of the seats fell off the tree. We've got the other seat attached. We've got the back seat. We've got our fuel tank. We've got gauge cluster. We've got some plastic tire for the spare. Pedals in there. Obviously a manual transmission. On this one, we've got a sweet looking exhaust system, which is nice that it's actually assembled and on its own. We can get it painted. We've got some wheel backs here, so we can paint those all together. We've got various body parts. This looks like the rear doors for the truck body. I'm not sure what this is. Part of maybe the Landau body or the buggy version. We'll find out. Oh, that's the roof. That's the roof right there. So that's what we're looking at for the truck version. Here's the body for the truck version, the hauler body, which is what I think those doors go on in the back. So it might have opening doors. We've got our Landau top. See where that little half moon window goes in? We've got our hood with cool little straps built in, little naked ducks there. So that's cool. You can paint it up as fabric. It's got nice creases in it if you choose to do the Landau version. And we've got our T-Bug body. Sharp looking body. And check out the fit. I already tried this. Look at the fit of the truck body on there. Nice. We can get that glued on. Whether we do it first, last, whenever we want, and even we can even test fit the hood. Nice looking. It's going to make a nice size model, and I do like that there are locator mounts, looks like, for the chassis, and big locator holes for those big bug-eye headlights so we get them on straight. I'm going to start gluing mine together, and I'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
Time to go over the parts. What do we got sitting in front of us? We got a cool looking rod that I'm building up. Now you can see there is a good amount of stuff I left on the chrome tree. I left the fin valve covers, the alternator, the fan cover. I thought those would look good on a custom in chrome. Of course, once I get a chance to look at the manual, I figure out what more parts are. These parts here are the intake for the carburetor. There's six of them there. I have one on the side. The parts that I identified as halves of a moon tank are the headlights. They're a goofy looking, cool retro looking headlight with this bump out on the top. So that's what those were. My mistake. Lanterns, of course, would be like the side lights, fog lights, and turn signals. We've got our bumpers here and various small pieces of chrome for bumper mounts. Windshield wipers, nice little horn. We got our brush guard bumpers, stuff like that. These cool scroll works in metal are for the Landau top, but there's absolutely nothing that says I couldn't paint those or not paint them, whatever I wanted, and put them on the side of the cargo doors on the side of the truck bed too. So might add that little bit of a detail on there and make it even cooler. So that is all set on the chrome tree. We're ready to go with that. We've got the exhaust and the wheel backs. I want those both in the metallic. So it's awesome that they're on the same tree. Same as these little parts here, steering box, steering link, wheel backs, and pedals. I want those in a metallic tone in my hot rod. So that's great that those are on the same tree. We've got, I can't find this part in there, and it doesn't look like a battery because it's got a mount on the top of it. I looked all through the manual. I can't find that little box anywhere. It's not part of the engine. And it wasn't part of the chassis that I could see, or the body anywhere. So I don't know what that part is. Let me know, folks, down in the comments. Maybe I left it out of somewhere. But anyways, I'm going to paint it in case I figure out what it is later. And then our weird belt and pulley system. Look at those little idlers. You got to get the belt around a corner. They must go through a lot of belts on this thing. All set up. That has to be painted all black. Got our chassis here. The chassis has a natural tweak in it. So I'm going to do my best to get that out of there as I work. I think when I glue the chassis onto the body, because see how it mounts into this cross pattern here? Pretty sure since the ends just hang off, see how that tightens it up? If I run glue in there and clamp it, when I glue it in, it looks like it comes out. So we'll see, we'll make sure. This is, as you saw, super, super fiddly. The back part mounts on tight and it's all styrene to styrene. So we're good there, and then I reinforced the chassis to the suspension joint with some super glue just to make sure it held. But getting that front axle on is very, very finicky. So I used copious amounts of super glue for all the linkages, the cross link, and then the tie rod across the steering tie rod. I also glued that to the chassis to make sure that all held on tight. I don't want that to break off later. I'll get paint on that. The little bit of a thicker super glue will just look like welds. It will look like a little bit thick of a weld. You won't even notice it. Spare tire mount, I definitely wanted to use on this one since it's there. That'll just add a little bit of accoutrement to the vehicle. And we're all set. So since you looked at the body already, that will glue on to the body. So that's looking cool. Right? Going to sit nice and jacked up like a hot rod. Pretty sweet. And then the hood will come down like so. We'll take the chassis off. The hood's going to come on like so. I left the tree on here so I can hold it and paint it because of the fact that this section is all covered with that awesome big chrome grill. This entire section's covered with the grill. So there's no need to worry about getting paint here. You're going to snip this off flush and you're going to be gluing that grill on. So that's good. We got the dashboard in and the steering. You can see how that's going to look. That'll be pretty cool. Cool, I'm saying cool a lot because it's cool, man. It's a Barris buggy. So that's all set. We got our spare tire, which just friction fit together, but I ran a little glue on the outside to knock the seam down without having to worry about sanding it. I will clip it off here, touch it up with some black, and we'll just hang that on the back of the car. It has a cover over it, but I'll just paint it black anyways, squeeze that spare wheel, this sweet looking one right here, into there, and we'll be all set. Then we come to the body. I think I can finally take the clamps off. The doors will operate if you so wish them to. And on this one, such a cute little hot rod that I kind of want them to. So I made sure to glue the frame carefully. If not, just cut off the hinges, glue everything shut, and you're done. Then we've got the side here, which, like I said, I don't know, I'm kind of feeling that scroll work, but maybe in black when I put it on there. Maybe that would look cool with all the black pinstriping and all the decoration and all that. So that's how the body goes together. I glued the roof on, and then as you saw me, I lined the windshield up to make sure it all worked. And that's it. We're all done. So I am going to start throwing paint on everything. Almost forgot to show you the Corvair engine. A lot of chrome pieces. Not a fan of that with engines. I'm going to be painting all over this anyways, so I don't mind the cloudiness from the super glue. It doesn't bug me at all. But if you do want it to hold, you can always sand or file the chrome off and use model glue and then treat it like that. But yeah, this is, and this goes into the chassis. These are your drive axles. So it will end up mounting underneath, and then you'll just pop those in each side. Those big holes are where those cups will go, and these are flexible enough to move out of the way. So that is it, and I am going to head everything over to paint right now.
Thank you.
As usual, on the car builds, I like to show off the insides before we put everything together so you can get a much better look at it. Vehicles tend to be so closed in, especially the customs and stuff. So let's take a look at what we're working on. You saw me work on the body. I did struggle with those pinstripe decals. There's nothing wrong with the decals in this one. Sometimes they were a little too thin or whatever, but these decals were just fine. The guy on the other side of the camera was just a little ham-fisted. They were looking so nice, and then I totally botched the one on the front fender and broke it and tore it. There was nothing I could do about it, so I removed them before they dried and went with some of the scroll work on the fenders. And of course, I did add the scrolls on the side, so that kind of works. The ones on the roofs, I did not screw up, so I left those on. Good thing I did do the striping around the cargo area. Then I added the little crosses on the back. So that actually looks nice as it is with those little straps molded into the hood with the buckles and everything. I really wanted to get those stripes on the fenders, but such is life and it will not be. So this is our cab and our interior. All I need to do with this is attach like the headlights and the lanterns on the glass and the lanterns on the back of the body for taillights, and then that will be set to go. The body will just be glued to the chassis from the bottom. The chassis is right here. You can see that lovely Corvair engine. I did things my own way on the Corvair engine. I don't care if they're color correct or anything. It does not matter at this point. This is a complete custom vehicle. I did differ from the directions for the engine. On the engine, they have the single carburetor feeding, you know, three cylinders on each side. They wanted you to attach this silver bar, which is here, with a little hole in the back. They wanted you to attach that to the carburetor and then put three velocity stacks on the top. But the way I looked at it is three velocity stacks to this air filter assembly and then down into the carburetor, it's a single carburetor. It's not like it has three, you know, carbs or anything like that. So I thought it was a much simpler plus easier for me to just do one velocity stack glued right to the top of each carburetor. It's a show car. I mean, that's absolutely fine. I blackwashed the inside of those stacks. I glued the exhaust on. The exhaust goes in really nice and looks awesome in that metallic and blacked out the tips. Got our chrome fan shroud, alternator on there. I think that came out to be kind of a sharp looking dealio. Got the wheels. I used the long center caps, the big cones on the back wheels. On the front, I just used the axle themselves, just pushed through a little bit. That looks very nice to me. So that is the chassis right there. That will glue underneath the body like we talked about, like so. I already took the tweak out of the chassis when the tires and the engine went in. It straightened the chassis. You can see it's sitting on all four wheels equally now, so it shouldn't be an issue. It just kind of corrected itself. We'll get the body on there. Look how tough that's going to look once we get it lined up on there. Get our little headlights on, get those glued in place, get our bumpers. You wouldn't have to use the bumpers if you don't want to. I'm gonna try to use them. Windshield wipers, we got our horn there, we got our moto meter for the front of the car, we got our spare tire. Now, since this is the cargo truck, you might not want to attach the spare tire, but you could do so in the back here if you just kind of hang it low, right there. To me, that looks cool. So I might just hang that and do without the rear bumper. We've got our exhaust, we got our rear tire on there. I may just do it like that and then attach the front bumper, which looks nice to me. I'll decide how I want to do everything, because when we come back, we'll have the final. Well, what do you think, folks? I had a fun time putting together the Barris T Buggy. I love these custom cars. This one's based off a real vehicle. I'm pretty sure it's real. Look at it. It looks pretty real in that picture. Like they had actually parked it somewhere and built it. If they didn't, whoever did the box art did amazing work on it. I haven't Googled it to see if it was a model and then they made that or if it was a real one. I should really do that. But hey, I'll let you guys tell me in the comments, because I know you like educating me with your automotive knowledge. Either way, I think this is a cool machine. The 60s, the 70s had such cool custom rods, and then they kind of fell out of favor. You don't see them a lot anymore. But Round 2 Models through MPC is bringing back all these kits that are super rare that haven't been seen, or try to bring them back to their original look. This thing is cool. I definitely wanted to do a full build of this one on the channel. As you can see in the back, I did use the rear bumper, because after looking at it, the way that I saw the rear bumper mount, I can just use that as a cradle for the tire. It covers up the original spare mount. It just cradles in the back of that area there. Doesn't drag on the ground and looks really cool. And in the truck version, it would mean you could still get the back doors open without a problem. I love the raked windshield with the lanterns on the side, the big bug lights, the little modal meter, the little gas plug, and the straps to hold the hood down. I added the scroll work on the side that was for the Landau version. You can see on the back here how you can now get those doors open. They recommended putting the lantern somewhere else, but on a box art, I don't see it on top. But I like them up here. And I painted mine gold with the red and the chrome on the front. Put my little horn in there. Got our seats and our little jump seat in the back. It's just a fun kit. In fact, if you wanted to, you could even mount this windshield open. And I'm thinking about it now, and I really should have, because I thought it would look cool, but I didn't know what angle everything would be at when I was done assembling. I really enjoyed the kit. You can kind of tell I'm excited about it. I like these custom ones because you can do them like the real one if it existed. You can do a version of it like I did. You can make it completely your own, different colors. Just go to town enjoying a custom vehicle. And these always draw a lot of attention on the shelf. Everyone and their brother can see a Hemi Cuda anytime on the internet. Everyone and their brother can go to a car show and see a Roadrunner or a Camaro driving on their street. Stuff like this, what is that? That thing's pretty neat. It's got a Corvair engine in it, which is cool just to have a neat customized Corvair engine. And I did my own little intake work on there, like I told you about. You can have the doors open. You can put the Landau top on there. Let's look at them on the box art again. These are your options. The truck version that I built, the Landau version, or the open buggy with a little roll bar and stuff like that. So you decide how you want to put yours together. Use the parts you want. Don't use the parts you don't want. Just enjoy yourself and have a fun time building an absolutely good time model kit. I enjoyed it. I'm glad that Round 2 Models sent this over for a review. This should be available soon, if not by the time this video comes out on Wednesday. If not, the links in the description will show you how to pre-order it and have it ready as soon as it's in stock. Your favorite model place will send it to you. As always, thanks for your nice comments, suggestions, information on the Barris T Buggy. If you know anything about it in the comments, I read every single comment, even though I don't get the time to reply to everybody anymore because it takes quite a while. I always enjoy them, and I enjoy your subscriptions and finding out how much you enjoy model kits and telling me about what you're building. We'll see all of you at the next review.